99.9 KISW.
Do you ever eat peanut butter and jelly sandwiches?
Absolutely.
Do you really?
Yeah.
I just was like having a total craving for one. I haven't had one in years.
You know what I like? I like it when it's on just your cheap ass white bread.
Is that where you like
it? Oh, yeah. I don't like any weird bread. I like your, you know, your Wonder type. You're just, I mean, not that Wonder's cheap. Am I getting in trouble here?
No, you're fine. You're fine. No.
I mean, just a square piece of white bread. You know what I'm saying?
Just like the total enriched white bread,
yeah,
right?
And you know what I like to do? I like to make them so just absolutely cool that they are spill. I have to eat it over the sink because it drips, you know?
Oh, yeah. So, I mean, how do you make yours? I mean, what, Jared, go ahead. Yeah, buddy, what's up?
So you're saying you don't like the darker breads is what you're saying?
Oh, yeah, you can't use wheat bread or oat bread or
no,
any of that stuff.
No pumpernickel.
No sourdough. It's got to be just...
There's rules to peanut butter and jelly.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Was there any darker breads at your wedding at all?
I don't know what he's talking about.
I think he's just trying to... You pull the race card all the time. Why don't you have brown bread? It's always about the white guy. Sometimes the white fluffy bread just tastes a little bit better with the peanut butter and jelly.
Well, here's how you make it. You take a peanut butter and you put it on one piece of bread, just a dry piece of bread,
okay,
right?
All right.
And then on the other side on the bread, you put butter.
Is that
and
what you do?
No margarine, and you don't be stingy with the butter.
Okay, you're
and
like
then,
my mom.
Right on top of that is where you put your jelly or your jam or whatever. I prefer either like red raspberry or apricot jam, and you just overdo it.
And then, all right.
And then you eat it over the sink because it's going to drip.
All right. That's not how I do it. I actually was grossed out because my mom used to put the massive amounts of butter on it, and I would just be like, what's wrong with you? What is this crap?
I overdo it so much about two-thirds of the way through the sandwich, I don't want it anymore, you know?
Dude, just clog my arteries, okay? Here's what I do. You got to take two pieces. I'm with you on the white bread, too, by the way.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't have it on sourdough or anything.
You don't
want
any nuts
moist.
In there. No.
It's got to be moist, fluffy, white, enriched bread.
Yeah, preferably the first two slices out of the bag.
But here's... Oh, dude, but you can't have the... Not the butt or the next... piece to the butt.
No, but I'm just saying like a new loaf.
Yeah.
So it's all, like
you
said, squishy fresh. Yeah.
Right. But that last piece and then the next piece I always throw out to the birds. I just huck it out the window and then I work my way down to the... And then I don't eat the two. So I basically, there's four pieces of bread in the bread that I don't eat.
Yeah.
But I'll take a nice fresh two slices and here's what I do. I throw peanut butter on both sides.
Okay.
You go peanut butter and peanut butter. And then, dude, seriously, you need an ice cream scooper for the jelly.
So you have to eat yours under the sink, too.
Oh, absolutely, dude. Absolutely. It just, every bite, just jelly just going everywhere. So because you throw jelly on top of both sides of the peanut butter massive amounts. And I'm a huge strawberry fan, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Strawberry
preserves. Yeah, that's good stuff.
Strawberry jam.
Yeah.
That is the action. Oh, I'm drooling right now, and I just ate. And then a nice glass of milk because that peanut butter sticks to your mouth like you read about.
Crunchy or creamy?
Creamy, for sure.
Yeah, me too. Absolutely.
I don't need any of the peanuts getting in the way. I enjoy the... I haven't had one in so long. It's been forever.
Yeah.
Those are the best. And then, you know, those... I don't want to go into the late night peanut butter and jelly and Cheeto stories, but, you know, you can...
Have you ever fried your peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
Never.
Oh, it's so good. Because the peanut butter starts to melt. Like, right in a pan, you know, butter the outside of the bread, flip it over.
Right, like a grilled cheese sandwich,
exactly.
But it's a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
But you can't overdo the peanut butter and jelly. Keep it at a reasonable level. Pan fry it, and then when you're eating it... Oh, it's so good because the peanut butter becomes melted.
What?
So it's like runny.
What?
Oh, it's so good. Just try it one time. Just trust me.
Dude.
Just trust me. So good.
All right. Well, looks like we got a call here. I don't know what it's about or whatever, but let's take a call from Lyle in North Bend. Let's talk to Lyle. Lyle, what's happening?
Hey, Double R, you gay bitch.
I didn't know that about you, Double R.
I've just been exploring a lot of new things.
Biatch.
What's up, Lyle?
Dude, you guys suck.
Yeah! Biatch.
What's up, man? What is this peanut butter and jelly sandwich topics, man? You guys can come up with something better than that.
We're talking about topics, dude. I was going to say something different that starts with do, but listen, dude, that was a conversation that just came up, okay? That wasn't something we planned. And you know what? If you got a problem with peanut butter and jelly, then go, I can't say yourself, okay? Because everybody can relate with peanut butter and jelly. I don't care who you are, what you do, how big of a man you are, or how big of a metrosexual you are. Everybody has a place in their heart for peanut butter and freaking jelly.
Dude, your topics blow, man. If you can't come up with anything smart, then at least be funny.
Kind of like you, right, Lyle?
Well, exactly like me.
Kind of like this fine conversation. So all of our topics, they just aren't getting it done for you, huh?
Oh, what's the weirdest thing that's happened to you at work? Come on, man. You can do better than that, can't you?
Okay, why don't you come up with a topic right now, buddy? What do you got for us?
I don't know. Something better than that,
Yeah,
though.
Congratulations. Yes. All right, go stick your head in a meat grinder.